Hello everyone, Davina here. Today we're going to have a go making a straw flute. Now for this all you will need is a straw, a plastic straw, and a pair of scissors. Now this one straw by itself will actually make a number of flutes. You can cut it into several pieces to make different pitched flutes, so high note flutes, low note flutes. For now we're going to cut just above where the bendy part of the straw is, just here. I'm also going to cut just below the bendy part of the straw, just removing that part. Now we've got two different size pieces here. I'm going to leave it as two different ones so you get a feel for how they're a bit different. Very simply, you're going to take one of the pieces and flatten the end. Just squeeze the end with your fingers, pinching it. Once you've squeezed the end into a bit of a point, you're going to cut an angle directly across, diagonally across. Then you're going to do the same thing in the other direction. You should now have a bit of a point on your straw, like so. You want to squish it a little bit further down, make sure it's nice and flat. We can do the same thing for our small flute. So we're going to squish the end, make it nice and flat. We're going to cut in one direction across it. So we've got a point going one way, cutting in the other direction across it. We've now got that triangular point, squashing the end a bit more. You now have two basic flutes, a high one and a low one. With our longer straw, we can actually make a more advanced flute that plays multiple notes rather than just the one note. The way to do this is to find the top of the flute, which is either one of the two points that you've made. And then to run along that edge, you're going to cut two holes. So little diagonal nicks with your scissors into the flute to make two little holes like so. Once you have these holes, you're now able to play three different notes on this flute. So you can play the flute as it is, with one hole covered by your fingers, or with two holes covered, three different notes. Lastly, you can change how high or low your flute plays, the pitch of the flute, by cutting the end. So the longer the flute is, the lower the note is going to be. If I cut higher, it will make a higher note. I hope you had fun making that. Now I'm going to pass you over to Peter, who's going to show you a variety of ways you can use your straw flute to make music.
Thanks, Davina. Now that you've made your straw flute, here's a quick tutorial on how to play it. Playing a note can be quite tricky at first, so don't worry if you can't get a sound straight away. You might just need to practice for a little bit. So start by placing the pointy end of the straw in your mouth, keeping your fingers on the holes. You'll need to squeeze the straw gently with your lips and blow quite hard to get a sound. And it sounds something like this. If you're struggling to get a sound, try putting more or less of the straw in your mouth until you find the sweet spot where it makes a note. If you have too little or too much of the straw in your mouth, it won't make a sound. So once you've managed to make a sound, you can try taking some of your fingers off the holes, which will change the pitch of the sound. You might need to blow harder when you do this, as high notes require more air. That sounds something like this. Now, try playing along with some of your favourite songs and see what happens.